The money that was supposed to be paid.
While investigating audit queries highlighted by the Auditor General's report for the financial year ended June 2022, the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament, chaired by Medard Lubega Sseggona, put on spot officials of Ugandan Netball Federation, led by the Federation President Sara Babirye Chityo, to explain accountability of 100 million shillings, which was allocated to the Federation to facilitate a trip of male national netball team players to the male championships in South Africa in September 2021.
How much money can be gotten from the bank in cash? Because like immediately 100 million landed, it was all withdrawn, and then you have already talked about the issue of there was already hotel booking. I wonder why even there was no direct payment transfer of the money to the bank.
Babidi revealed that the Federation received only 70 million shillings out of the 100 million shillings that was meant to facilitate the trip, but three executive members of the Federation, including Richard Muhumuza, Amina Mande and Aida Nabusi, connived and gave 30 million shillings to the General Secretary of the National Council of Sports as a kickback.
These three people, when they started these issues of taking funds in the names of kickbacks, we got disagreements. And I'm talking about the treasurer who had all these vouchers. I'm talking about the general secretary, the one in charge of minutes. I'm talking about the vice president technical, who prepared the team, prepared the budget, and was the head of delegation. So time came and I was not in charge of anything. I am asking that on the prepared accountability from Muhumuza down, the president, Honorable Sara, needed to be the one authorizing the accountability, and she signed. My question is she the one who signed or not?
She accused the trio of forging documents and her signatures to concoct accounts which they submitted to the National Council of Sports for clearance.
Honorable Sara says this document is not hers. It was a doctored document. I started looking at the documents that have been submitted to us by the National Council. So you'll realize that Muhumuza Richard paid some payments and they were authorized, always authorized by Honorable Sara, paid by Muhumuza.
So you have to be careful. That's why the chair was advising that there are some internal issues we have to resolve. That is not for... That cannot be resolved in the presence of the witnesses.
The committee also wanted accountability of 139 million shillings, which was allocated to the Netball Federation to facilitate the Namibia trip for Africa Netball Championships and Africa Penty Series. It was discovered that although organizers had invited 17 people who they were ready to facilitate, the Federation instead inflated the delegation to 27 people and went on to request for facilitation from the government.
We are said to have received 139,347,810.
Breaks down on what we were supposed to pay for as a country or federation. So I'm looking at, okay, they prepared the budget. Basing on what? You'll get to know that I actually got shocked reaching Namibia and realizing they only needed 17 people and they had contributed. We were not supposed to pay for it.
So you were as well shocked.
Yes,
that they had contributed.
Yes, Honorable Chair.
But now you also paid fully.
Yes, Honorable Chair, because I realized at the end.
Did people acknowledge receipt of this 500,000?
They did, Honorable Chair.
Where is the evidence?
Honorable Chair, I request that it will be part of what I'll submit on Wednesday.
The committee resolved to engage signature experts and summon the three accused executive members of Uganda Netball Federation to show up and explain.
Because you can see the federation is divided, so we must cheer from all sides.
Some MPs have proposed reforms in the running of the sports federation.
This trade-off of accusations, we may need to change the law to make sure that they operate in one way or another.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.